Hello dear fans, friends and subscribers. Welcome to this cricket happening show as usual. Well, I'm going to give you a first day's play report on the deciding test match which was played today at Palakkale between Pakistan and Sri Lanka. And well, it was Pakistan, I think definitely, I think Pakistan and Sri Lanka were sharing the honors here, because thanks to Dimuth Karunaratne, who scored his second test century in a very, very nice manner. In fact, he was the only one who looked confident against all the Pakistani bowlers, especially Asir Shah, who was really spinning a web around the Sri Lankan batsmen, and he was really bringing them to their doom, as once again Asir Shah proved to be the nemesis for Sri Lanka as he picked up a four wickets today. Well, I'll come back to that. And also in this cricket happening show, I will be looking at what a start South Africa had in their first game of their Bangladesh tour here, with a very comprehensive victory against, in fact, it was a T20 game which was played between the Bangladesh Cricket Board 11 and South Africa, and South Africa won it very, very comfortably by 8 wickets. And as I'm talking to you, there's one game, one tour game which is going on between Essex and Australia. Yesterday, we saw Essex really give a firm reply to Australia's 562 when Westley, the opener, made an impressive 144, and also Ravi Bapara showing some great panache here by making 107 runs with 14 boundaries. And I'll come back to that. I'll give you a cricket update on that. As now I see that Australia are, right now as I'm speaking to you, they are in some sort of strife here, because they've already lost 4 wickets for 81 runs. I'll come back to that later. But first, let me start off with this full report on the final day's play in this final test match between Sri Lanka and Pakistan, just, which was played at Palakkale. Well, I probably made a mistake yesterday, or rather the venue was changed, one does not know. It was Palakkale where actually this match was played. Probably they changed the venue, I wouldn't know, because initially it was supposed to be in Kandy, if I'm not wrong. But anyways, it's all good for cricket. And stumps on day one, the Pakistan were the ones who actually won the toss. In fact, Pakistan were the ones who won the toss. And they decided to insert Sri Lankans into field, inserted the Sri Lankans to bat, and the precise reason was that they would have definitely felt that there was something in it for the seamers, and they were definitely right on that score, no doubt about it. And Sri Lanka, well, they finished off. I mean, they finished at stumps on day one on a score of 272 for 8. Now, as far as this match was concerned, well, Pakistan, the only surprise for me was that Pakistan decided to go with an inexperienced pace bowling lineup. In fact, we know Wahab Riaz was not there. Wahab Riaz was out due to injury. And one was probably hoping that Junaid Khan, the experienced person, would be there. But they decided to go in for some real new faces. In the sense, not new faces, some inexperienced bowlers who have definitely played some test cricket. But not to the extent that probably Junaid Khan would have played. But I thought it was a sort of a selection which was probably puzzling me right now, probably puzzling me. But well, I still feel that the Pakistani young bowlers have done a good job here. Rahat Ali, Ehsan Adil, and Imran Khan were the bowlers who were in operation. So they decided to go with a three-pronged pace attack. But the only thing which was lacking in that was experience. But I thought that was more than made up by Yasir Shah's leg spin, who took 4 for 77. Well, and out of the three bowlers, Rahat Ali picked up 2 wickets. Other than Ehsan Adil and Imran Khan, who also bowled well, were wicketless. Just coming to that, so it all started with, as I said, it was a good toss to win. Pakistan, well, I wouldn't say the bowlers really started in the right direction. With Rahat Ali, Ehsan Adil actually spraying the ball in all. I mean, they were not really bowling to a good line, and we were seeing some short stuff being served to the Sri Lankan openers, which Karunaratne and Silva really took a toll off. But well, things were going on, and then finally, it took some time for for the Pakistani inexperienced pace bowling lineup of Rahat Ali Ehsan, Adil Imran Khan to hit their straps. And once they did so, the reward started coming, with Kaushal Silva being the first victim as he nicked one ball which was moving away from Rahat Ali into the hands of Sarfraz Ahmed, and he was walking back after making 9 runs with 2 boundaries. So that made it 15 for 1. In walked in Upal Taranga. And Upal Taranga, as you know, was replaced Kumar Sangakkara. Kumar Sangakkara not playing this test match. Upal Taranga making a comeback into test cricket. And Upal Taranga, well, Upal Taranga has this ability where outside the off stump he's a bit fallible, and we saw that he was playing and missing quite times, and that was the time he said that the bowlers were really on the mark. Rahat Ali Ehsan, Adil Imran Khan, and they were really, really testing the batsman. Karunaratne was staying firm, but he was playing with lots of assurance. And this partnership slowly revived things for Sri Lanka a great bit, as Sri Lanka went into lunch at 85 for 1 with Karunaratne and Taranga in the middle. Now, Karunaratne had to really, really wait for the loose delivery to dispatch it to the fence. But what was good about Karunaratne's batting was that he was playing straight and he was hitting some very good strokes down the ground, and it was interspersed with some very good mixed defense from Karunaratne. Taranga, well, he really decided, Taranga being a stroke player, he decided to play some very good strokes, and then the thing started happening for Pakistan after lunchtime. As in fact, it was Imran Khan was also very impressive. He was testing the batsmen by bowling some very good outswingers and inswingers, and then finally, Yunis Khan, the Pakistan captain, decided that he's going to throw the ball to Yasir Shah, the random leg spinner, and that was a real timely thing done by Yunis Khan, and there came the rewards pretty quickly. And then it was something that the Sri Lankan innings started going downhill after that, as the first wicket to be taken was of Upal Taranga. When Upal Taranga got a ball from Yasir Shah, which turned, and Upal Taranga, I thought he was probably a half cock there, and he was caught by Yunis Khan, but not before making a very good comeback 46 with 6 boundaries. So that made it 106 for 2. Tirumani came in, and Tirumani continued to struggle with Yasir Shah bowling a very good googly, I would say, and getting him caught by the substitute Babar Azam for 11 with 2 boundaries. And Angelo Matthews also followed back to the pavilion, being a victim of Yasir Shah for 3. And that really, really meant that Sri Lanka were getting into some real strife there at 137 for 4. In walked in Jahan Mubarak. Now, Jahan Mubarak, of whom much as was said by Jonty Rhodes, the South African, former South African great fielder. Well, Jahan Mubarak was included in the lineup. Jahan Mubarak, well, he played some very good strokes, no doubt about it. He was really trying to play himself in along with Karunaratne, because they definitely needed someone to actually stay at the crease for a long time, and one was hoping that Jahan Mubarak could do that on his comeback, but unfortunately that was not the case. Mubarak, well, probably had a rush of blood, as he was, Yasir Shah, the random leg spinner, was bowling so well with a lot of dip, a lot of good loop. He was having great variations. He was troubling the batsman, beating them quite a number of times. And then finally, it was Jahan Mubarak and Karunaratne who were there in the middle, probably getting a bit frustrated there with runs really, really drying up. It was Jahan Mubarak who actually left the crease to have a go at Yasir Shah. And that ended up with Sarfraz Ahmed stumping him for 25 with 4 boundaries. So that partnership, which also was a very good partnership, which yielded some very good runs for Sri Lanka, and very welcome runs that way, probably in partnership of around 60-odd runs. But then Jahan Mubarak was walking 25 with 4 boundaries, made 204 for 5. And then Karunaratne was joined in by Dinesh Chandimal. Well, Dinesh Chandimal, we all know that he's not in some good form. Decided to play around with Karunaratne, but then now it was the time for Rahat Ali to really, really get in and pick up a wicket, and that's what he precisely did when Rahat Ali trapped Dinesh Chandimal LBW for 24 with two fours. That made the score. So before that happened, in fact, Karunaratne, who had done, and you know, the score, I mean, when Jahan Mubarak was out, the score was 204, and then another 44 runs were added between Karunaratne and Dinesh Chandimal, and then Azhar Ali was put into the attack. Now, that was a very smart move by Misbah-ul Haq, probably trying to see whether Azhar Ali can do something with his leg breaks, because he saw that Yasir Shah has been really, really having a great time against the Sri Lankan batsman, and he was doing something. So probably to add some sort of a psychological twist to it, he decided to put in Azhar Ali to bowl, the part-timer. And what an over for Azhar Ali. He came in and, when this particular stand between Karunaratne and Chandimal was progressing, and Karunaratne had reached his second test century, grafting his way down to 130 runs with 14 boundaries. This was Azhar Ali. Now, defeating Karunaratne, he came in and defeated Karunaratne with a googly that turned, and Karunaratne was found groping there. He was out of the crease, and Sarfraz Ahmed had whipped off the bails. What a stumping there. And Karunaratne, what a wicket. I mean, Azhar Ali coming in and breaking, getting the prize wicket that Pakistan direly needed, and that of Karunaratne. But Karunaratne, not before playing a very, very impressive knock, a grafting innings of 130 with 14 boundaries. So he was sent back to the pavilion. And in the same over, it was Azhar Ali who really changed the complexion of the game when he had Dhamika Prasad out to the very first delivery that he faced, when this was not a delivery that should have really fetched a wicket, because as you know, leg spinners normally bowl a lot of long hops, and this was one of those long hops which Dhamika Prasad decided to dispatch it to the fence, but Yasir Shah took a good catch, and two wickets and two balls for Azhar Ali, and suddenly the Sri Lankan innings was once again plummeting as the score read 248 for 7. After that, Rahat Ali trapped Chandimal LBW for 24, and then finally, when stumps were drawn, Tarindu Kaushal was not out on 17 with 3 boundaries, Lakmal was not out on 1, and the Sri Lankan score stood at 272 for 8 at close of play. Now, looking at the bowling, Rahat Ali bowled well, I thought, 19 overs, 2 maidens, 274. Ehsan Azil, 14 overs, 3 maidens, none for 37. Imran Khan, I thought, even though he couldn't get the wickets, I thought he was a bit trifle unlucky not to get amongst the wickets, but I thought he really, really tested the Sri Lankan batsman with his away movement and in movement. 15 overs, 3 maidens, none for 46. But Yasir Shah was the one who really mesmerized the Sri Lankan batsman here. 31 overs, 4 maidens, 77 runs and 4 wickets, and continued to be the scourge of the Sri Lankan batsman in this test series, as Azhar Ali, 7 overs, no maiden, 2 for 35. And that I thought was a brave move by Misbah-ul Haq, the very intelligent move by the Pakistan captain, Misbah-ul Haq, to bring in Azhar Ali. And Azhar Ali responded by getting two important wickets, and that too, the prize wicket of Karunaratne, who had his second test century for 130 with 14 fours. But what a knock from Karunaratne. Karunaratne, I would say, really played a remarkable knock, and it was wonderful to see Karunaratne grafting and grinding his way to his second test century. Well, from here, so tomorrow's second day's play should be an interesting affair at Palakkad. It all depends on whether Pakistan can quickly wrap this up. So that depends on Pakistan, if they can quickly wrap it up. If they can quickly wrap it up, they would have everything for themselves. So probably Pakistan will be hoping that they could keep Sri Lanka to under 300 tomorrow. So one has to wait and watch. Now I'm going to take you down to the first game of the South African tour of Bangladesh. And this was a T20 game. It was played at the Khan Sahib Osman Ali Stadium in Fathullah. And it was Bangladesh who actually lost the match. South Africans winning the match comfortably by 8 wickets. Bangladesh in their 20 overs. In fact, they couldn't even play their 20 overs, which was a bit of a shame, I thought, because they were all out for 99 in 18 overs. Now, just talking about the scoreboard of the Bangladeshi batting here. Anamul Haq was, Kyle Abbott was the one who picked up two wickets pretty quickly. He sent both the openers into the hut. Ronnie Talukdar was bowled by Abbott for one. Anamul Haq was bowled by Abbott for three. Imrul Case was the highest scorer with 29 of 24 balls with three fours. Shaikat Ali made five. Shubhgat Ahum making 18 of 19 with two fours. Mossadegh Hussain ducked. Mahmoodul Hussain five. Sohag Ghazi, who was selected, as you know, into the T20 Bangladesh main team. And today he contributed 13 runs of 8 balls with 1-4 and 1-6. Abdul Hassan 5, Abdul Razak 8, and 99 all out. Not a good, but definitely it was a warm-up game, I would say, for both the teams. Abbott 2 for 2, Rabada 1 for 10, and in fact, South Africans, I would say, that Fungiso got 2 for 19. David Wiese had a good 3-wicket haul for 13 and 1 for 11. Eddie Lee, who is supposed to be a promising leg spinner, who is playing, who has been brought on this Bangladesh tour. South Africa, the target was 100 to get from 20 overs. Quinton de Kock, in fact, just to have a hit, they wanted to give everyone some batting practice there. Quinton de Kock retired out 35 of 24 balls with 6 fours. De Villiers retired out 25 of 19 balls with 4 fours. Dumini not out 17. Miller not out 20. Game over, 101 for 2. And South Africa winning the match. It was a real warm-up match here. And South Africa really started off on the right foot here by actually beating Bangladesh in the first match of their tour. Well, from here, I will take you down to the Australian tour of England. And right now, as I'm talking to you, there is a game going on between Essex and Australia. As I said, Westley hit a century, Ravi Bopara making a century, and I'm trying to get to that score right now. Just trying to see what is the situation while I'm talking to you. I do see that Australians have been reduced to 91 for 4. Michael Clarke is there, not out on 42. Chris Rogers making 32. Warner was out for 4. Adam Woods for 1. And Watson was LBW, but Ryan Chandoshad for 1. So, well, as far as the Essex innings was concerned, the Essex innings, well, Mitchell Starc had a 6-wicket haul, so he came back pretty hard there on Essex. 6 for 51, so that was a good outing for Mitchell Starc there just before the Test series. And 107 to Bopara with 14 fours, 36 from Ryan Chandoshad's bat, 36 with 6 fours and 1-6. Foster making 23. Well, I'm not going to go into any of those details, but as I said, tomorrow, as you know, on Saturday, it's going to be a late night cricket show as usual. And on this late night cricket show, I'll be covering the second day's play between Pakistan and Sri Lanka in the third and final test match. Well, dear fans and subscribers, I hope you all like this cricket show of mine, and I'm hoping to see you all tomorrow on my late night cricket show, that's on a Saturday. Until then, it's goodbye. Thank you.